My name is Beverley Jane Stewart. I'm an artist. I specialise in Jewish culture in Britain. It's about looking at things from the past to the present, so you don't make the judgment of the here and the now, and look at the layers of how things have been built up. When I went to Lincoln, that was a very good atmospheric play. Past that was very easy to identify. You could connect with Jewish life very easily and imagine what it was like to live in medieval Britain. And then I brought it up to today and how much better it is today with people having more tolerance. Let me go through with you how I developed this picture. To start with, I took photographs of the castle because the monarchy were very strong. And here you can see the gated area, which brings you through into where the Jews used to live. This is the entrance of the castle, and this is one of the walls. We then go into the cathedral, which is actually opposite the castle. This is all lit up with all its glory in today's world. And this was the little tomb of, we used to be St. Hugh, is now Little Hugh. And the explanation that this was a racial act and we've moved on. Coming down the road, you come to where the old houses were, the old stone houses. You can see the cathedral in the distance. We have a little Norman house. Used to be one time called Aaron's house. And Aaron was a Jew who was a moneylender in medieval times. He didn't actually live there. That's why now they call it the Norman house. But he would have lived in a house very similar and in the same sort of location. Here comes Jews' Court, which was the synagogue and where the rabbi of a Jewish family lived next door. And this is what it used to be like in medieval times. These were open areas for shops and people used to live on the first floor. Inside the first floor we now have the synagogue, liberal synagogue, and it's all laid out ready for the service. When we come to this area, this is another interesting area. When I was at the collection, I came across the lateral sorter, which was about medieval life in Lincoln. And in this one, this is a photocopy of a research by Cecil Roth, who went into the rolls at the time, which were parchment recording Jewish life in medieval world in the government. Some of the people did illustrations of Jews, and they're very similar to this. So you can start making comparisons. And it shows imagery with the extended nose and the evil ears. And you can see a similarity in some of the pictures that were shown in the lateral sorter of showing Jews in blue, which means the other, you don't associate with them, and elongated features like the nose. So I thought that was all important to create the atmosphere.
Here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire 94.9 FM, been talking on an interesting project. Beverley Jane Stewart's work depicts life as a Jew in multicultural Britain. She's in Lincoln today to shoot a film about the project because one of the recent paintings featured the city. You can see the painting on our Facebook page now. The detail, I have to say, when I saw this last week when I was looking through the information, I found so fascinating. I said, can we get Beverley Jane in on the programme? And here she is. Good morning.
Good morning.
You've got a busy day today, haven't you?
Yes, I'm going to see the Dean of the Cathedral.
Hugh was a young Christian boy who was found murdered in the Jewish area of Lincoln. This immediately set up a whole persecution of the Jews. The Christians thought that they had murdered this young lad, and so it became the excuse for persecution, which led, as we know, to the expulsion of Jews, not only from Lincoln, but from the country generally.
And I'm also going to Jews' Court and meeting the president of the synagogue, because the community has re-established itself here. What I find so fascinating about the whole project is that after all these years after the expulsion, the Jews have come back. Do you find that the community is very welcoming, the Lincoln community itself?
Yeah, hugely, yes. The bishop comes to services, the dean of the cathedral comes to services, not every day, but they've been and they come. We have an annual faith walk, which Muslims, Hindus, Sikhs, Baha'i.
What I love about your work and the image I was looking at of Lincoln, it's sort of divided in two, but not a straight line. It's divided in two. So the top left-hand corner is old Lincoln. The bottom right corner is the more modern Lincoln. And do you thoroughly research every place that you paint?
Yes, I mean, very deeply. I mean, this one, I went to the British Library to research what it was like to be a Jew in that period. If you look into the sky of the picture, you see the Jew in medieval times, and he's been squashed between the two hands of the forces, one of the church, the cathedral, the church, and the other of the monarchy. And in between, he's trying to count his money, he's trying to do his job, the coins are falling all over the place down below. I mean, that's why Lincoln is so fantastic, because it's all there, and you can put yourself back into time, and then you can reverse it to today. And when I did it back into time, my colours are blues, which are cold, somber, and then when you bring it to today, the colours become stronger, warmer, the cathedral is rebuilt, it looks golden and welcoming.